Anderson has always been a suck-up.
Yeah.
But maybe now more so than ever. But when you talk about titles and changing hands, the announcement that was made on SmackDown, so huge. The fact that they're going to unify the World Championship and the WWF title at Vengeance that night, only a few weeks away, is going to be off the chart.
It certainly is. And, of course, came about as a deal, a compromise made between the two even owners of the World Wrestling Federation. That, of course, is Vince McMahon and his business partner, Ric Flair, who was the one who purchased the shares of the World Wrestling Federation that were previously owned by Shane McMahon and Stephanie McMahon.
He bet on a winner.
He certainly did.
Ric Flair said it. He bet on a winner. And if there's anybody that can appreciate betting on a winner, it'd be me. And I like the fact that Ric Flair is half owner now of the WWF, because if Vince McMahon was completely in charge now, it would not be a good thing. It would be a bad thing.
Yeah, and I know as Christian has just knocked Spike Dudley down, Christian's going to really try to dictate the pace, but Spike certainly has that heart, that tremendous heart. He will never give up, no matter what Christian or anybody else does to him.
Okay, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, so we look at the dynamic now with Vince McMahon, half owner, Ric Flair, half owner, Stone Cold Steve Austin in the crosshairs now of Mr. McMahon's
right.
onslaught, and that's where Christian, the Dudleys, and Test and William Regal all fit in.
Oh, my goodness!
Well, the Centaur off the apron, the European champion is down.
Well, take care. Think about this huge move by Spike Dudley. Think about this. We go into Vengeance. Normally, the fans get, you know, one main event. They're going to get three at Vengeance. You know, when The Rock takes on Jericho, Stone Cold against Kurt Angle, then the winners of both of those matches compete. Oh my goodness, here's a roll-up kick.
That's right, victory roll. Oh, indeed, victory, it almost did.
The very same night at Vengeance in San Diego, California, Sunday, December 9th.
Oh, Spike went for it again and paid for it.
The two winners of that, both of those matches, fight the very same night to unify the title.
That was all part of the compromise on SmackDown on Thanksgiving night, where it was agreed that Kurt Angle will take on Stone Cold Steve Austin for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. The World Championship will be on the line as The Rock defends against Y2J, and then the winner of those two matches, the winners will meet later on in the night to cap off Vengeance in one of the biggest pay-per-view extravaganzas. What a way to wrap up 2001.
Oh, I tell you what, 2002 looks brighter than ever.
Oh, there is almost a pinfall scored by Christian.
You know, when you think about it, what could be any better? This past week, Thanksgiving, I ate a lot. Then we're going to go to San Diego, California. We're going to be out on the beaches. Huge Vengeance. And then the New Year's comes. Of course, that's going to be a huge party for the coach. And then come 2002.
Oh, man.
I'm so excited.
Man.
This is such a great week. I am so excited.
It really is.
Plus,
you know,
I'm going home this week. I'm going home, KK.
Oklahoma City and Wichita, Kansas this upcoming week for Raw. And what a huge event it's going to be at Wichita this Tuesday. We invite you all to be there. And now, the European champion in firm control. Vertical suplex. And look, he's holding Spike Dudley, allowing all the blood to rush to Spike's head, making that move even more impactful.
Very precarious.
Wait a second.
Wait a minute, cover!
I'm out of my seat because he's like, I'm going to be a limousine driving, jet flying, kissing all the girls.
Stealing all the girls.
Are you with me? Oh, my goodness. It's good stuff.
I don't think Vince McMahon has ever said woo in his life.
Said what?
Woo! Everybody needs to woo once in a while.
Oh, yeah. I plan on doing it. They just did it.
That's
crowd
right.
did it, you know.
Well, I'll tell you what,
like to woo all the time.
One of the greatest champions, of course, you know, in the history of this industry, Ric Flair, now making the transition into ownership, as we've seen with Michael Jordan and with Wayne Gretzky. A lot of former great athletes making the transition into ownership. Mario Lemieux in that group as well. But I think Ric Flair still is going to have a major impact on what happens now in a behind-the-scenes capacity.
Well, Ric Flair has always been very, as you say, impactful.
Yes.
Certainly on the microphone and in the ring. And now he's going to have to be impactful as a corporate owner, because we know what Vince McMahon brings to the table as an owner. We know how vindictive he can be, how power-hungry Vince McMahon really is. Ric Flair is going to have to be that power-hungry, or Vince McMahon could take him down as well.
We knew going into Survivor Series that the face of sports entertainment was going to change forever because one company was going to be gone.
Sure.
So 24 hours later, little did we know the depth and gravity to which those changes would take place. Not only was the World Wrestling Federation successful and the alliance done and gone, but 50% ownership of the World Wrestling Federation goes to Ric Flair.
And I think, KK...
Oh, wait a minute. Sunset flip. Two count only.
I think that Vince McMahon would say that he doesn't play well with others.
No, that's true. But you know what? Ric Flair doesn't take a back step either from anybody, as Spike now builds up the head of steam. You think that's one of those big egos that we're talking about there? Ric Flair's got a pretty good sized ego.
Well, I tell you what, and why shouldn't he? The brother's had women for years. He's been styling for years.
Oh,
he's been in limo for years.
He almost had a new European champion crown there.
I mean, now that I think about it, when you talk about Ric Flair's lifestyle, maybe I've been trying to emulate him for years.
Please. Two. Almost had him. Spike Dudley will not give up.
Well,
you in the Nature Boy.
Well,
please.
No, what I'm saying is I'm not putting myself in the Nature Boy's category. What I'm saying is that, you know, maybe 15, 20 years from now, after the legacy has been set day in and day out, then maybe they can say, oh, yeah, they kind of live the same type of lifestyle.
Oh, yeah, you and Mr. Flair, I'm sure.
At least when it comes to the women.
That's, you know, 50%. He's half your boss, you know that.
I understand that.
You better be respectful to him.
I am being respectful. A player is always respectful to another player.
I'll tell you what, this Spike Dudley will not give
up. He's tremendous.
And even though he didn't score the pinfall there on that occasion, he is still in this matchup. Christian thought he was in the driver's seat, and Spike Dudley refuses to quit. And now Spike extricates himself from another position. Here we go, Dudley.
Oh!